Hello, my name is Alexander Scheidel. I'm a development engineer for Steinecker, and I'm here responsible for the concepts of oat-based production and the alternative protein production concepts at Krones. Well, we have three concepts for our oat milk or oat drink production here at Krones. That means we have a first concept for a quick market entry where you don't need to do a hydrolysis step by itself. So you are using syrup or oat-based syrup, which is mixed with water and other additives in mixing tanks. Then it has to be thermal treated in our UHT systems, and after that it can be bottled. It's for a very quick market entry. A second concept is also for a quick market entry if you have already some equipment in your facility. That means you just need some powders or oat flour, which you have to hydrolyze in hydrolysis tanks. And after that, you have to separate it by a decanter centrifuge, and you use it then as the oat base from the first concept in the same further processes that you used in the first concept. And our third concept is the most complicated concept, but the holistic energy concept. It means we are using our meshing vessels or our hydrolysis vessels from the brewing technology, where you can have higher amounts of solid content of the oat flour, and we can go there in this concept also from the oat kernels and also from oat flakes to produce it in our facility. And it has the best energy footprint and the most energy savings in our concept. The hydrolysis is the key process for the oat drink production. It means the kernels, the oat kernels or other grains, consist of amylose and amylopectin. It's the starch. And the starch consists of a chain of different glucose molecules. And this chain of starch has to be degraded into smaller molecules. And for this, you need enzymes. And the enzymatic hydrolysis degrades the starch into sugars and lowers the viscosity of your product and is necessary for the final balance of sweetness and mouthfeel of your product. The third concept of us is the holistic energy concept, which is very important for this concept. That means we are using our meshing vessels from the brewing industry with inner pillow plates, where we can use low heating temperatures. That means we prevent fouling on the heat surfaces. That's one important fact. The second important fact is that we can use lower temperatures for heating up. That means we need less energy than in the other concepts. And we can add the enzymes in the hydrolysis vessels during the mixing of the mesh, during the mixing of the grains and the water. And our concept consists of a cold water tank, a warm water tank, and an energy storage tank. And we want to recuperate the energy and the thermal energy on every step we can do it. That means we lower the energy consumption of the whole production in this concept.